everyone. We're so glad that you have joined us tonight for our Wednesday night at Dothan First at Home. Tonight we have Pastors Josh and Natalie with us, our amazing kids pastors. Say hello to them.
Yes.
They are awesome. We love them so much. School is starting.
Yep, and
I know for our teachers that most of them have already gone back and started working on their classrooms and working on different things online. For the students who are going to be doing it online, I know our private schools are going back next week, our county schools. I know our city schools are holding off till after September, but we are going to be praying for you guys. In fact, at the end of this tonight, we're going to have a special time of praying over the students and the teachers for your school year that's coming up here. And I know there's been a lot. This has been a weird.
Yes.
Let's just say weird. 2020's been just weird.
Yeah.
Okay? And I guess I could probably come up with a different word than that. But it's just weird.
Very different.
It's just so different.
Very different.
And all the uncertainty.
Right.
And so we just need to pray for our students and our teachers and our parents.
Yes.
Our parents. Bless their hearts too.
Yes, and a lot of those parents may be doing distance learning or homeschooling for this because they have to do online.
Right.
And I know you parents, of you that had to do that at the end of the school year last semester and now at the beginning of the school year this year. I know that's not easy, especially for those parents that were both parents working.
Challenge
it just
for sure.
Makes it much more challenging. So we just want to keep them lifted up.
Absolutely. We're going to have a time of prayer at the end of this, but we have some exciting things happening.
We do, yes, lots of exciting things.
We are very pumped about.
Yeah, so there's some things that you guys have already been doing. This last few weeks, you've been preparing for what we call Zoo Camp.
Yes.
Those students, didn't get to go to camp this year,
right.
So you made it work for them, which I think is so awesome. It's so loving of you guys to think of them that way.
No, camp is one of our favorite things
to
do. We had to bring camp.
That's right. Yeah. If you can't go to camp,
bring
camp
to you.
That's right.
Y'all did a wonderful job.
Thank you for that. We, of course, have been up in the sanctuary while you've been doing it,
sure.
But we've heard and seen so many good things. Tell us a little bit about what's been going on with our zoo camp.
It has been awesome. A lot of fun. Camp is a great time for kids in their life. You know, being able to go there, you make some of your just greatest memories and talk about epic moments that usually happens at camp, you know. So, and we've had the pleasure of being able to host camp from church as a ministry for many years. This year was one year that we just couldn't do it for obvious reasons, but you know, we felt like, you know, we're going to bring camp to them. So it's been amazing. It really has. We've seen kids just engage, having fun, learning in a different way, and that's what camp is all about.
That's right.
So it's been a lot of excitement. We've had two teams that have been earning points playing these competitions.
Yeah, really.
No contact,
I love that competition.
Friendly book fears, right? Competitions, camp competitions. They've been really excited, and coming up soon, we're going to find out which team won.
Okay.
To that, they're going to be finding out who's going to get this big prize, and the losing team, because there are no losers in the kingdom of God, but you know, the other team, their team captain is going to be slimed, so there's a whole dynamic there that they're looking forward to, for sure.
Well, you have a blue team and a red team.
Yeah,
right.
Yeah. Well, whether your child is on the blue or the red team, it's going to be a lot of fun.
Yeah.
And they're not going to want to miss one single week coming up, because we're kind of coming to the close of this, and we'll have a special event kind of at the end to cap things off.
Yes. It's going to be awesome. We're going to be going outside with the kids and just doing some outdoor field games with them. So we'll be sending out some information on that coming up here soon.
Dressed accordingly.
But it's going to be, we're going to be outside, because what is camp without being able to be outside?
That's right.
You know, and so we're going to be taking the kids outside, and it's going to involve some water balloons. I will say that.
So. Okay, so parents, you heard that. You'll be getting more information, but
dress
accordingly.
That's right. So this would be between Vacation Bible School and camp. You guys are merging the two to just make an amazing experience on Sunday morning.
That's right.
And we're so proud of you guys and what you're doing. Thank you so much. We're so blessed that you're here and bringing vision. And speaking of vision, there's not just things that have happened or things that are about to happen in the next couple weeks, but there is something that's about to happen that is of epic proportion.
Oh, Lord.
But it is a surprise right now. We are going to announce this Sunday some amazing vision that we have been waiting on, and it's just, we're thrilled to be able to announce this to our entire congregation, but we can't tell now.
No.
We're just going to leave it under wraps, but short version is, if I can just give like a hint, is that it has to do with children's ministry.
That's right.
Okay. And it is going to be big.
Yeah. It is.
It's going to be big, and I'm so excited about the vision that we collectively get to carry.
That's right.
The
yep,
Lord's vision that we collectively carry.
Because we love honored. Kids.
Yes. Yes. That's our heartbeat. That's God's heartbeat.
Love kids.
Yes. Yeah. Well, now I will say this. I know we're talking about elementary age from first to fifth grade, but we have our nursery ministry.
Yes.
And we've been waiting.
Do.
Yes, I know.
Yes.
We have been waiting for a while to see the timing. Of where we can reopen. So I'll leave it to you, Pastor Natalie.
Yes.
Let's talk about it.
Yeah, you know, obviously, in our hearts, we just want to get back at it. Yeah. I want to see all of our babies, our preschoolers, our toddlers. We miss them, our teachers. I'm in contact with all of our nursery workers, our teachers. They just want to get back at it. But we have been, you know, prayerfully considering what day to open back up. And, you know, like you said, this is just a weird time. It really is. And so we want to make sure that we are doing everything that we possibly can to open back safely.
Right.
And so with that in mind, we do have a date that we are preparing for. We are excited. I'm so thrilled to get to just go back at it. And so we have August 23rd as our date that we're going to come back with nursery, with all of nursery. And I'll be making sure to send out emails with all the details for all of that, but we're just so excited, and we're gonna make sure that your babies, your toddlers, your preschoolers, all of them are safe, and that we're just doing everything that we possibly can.
Yeah, I appreciate that so much.
Absolutely.
Pastor Natalie works so hard, and like I know some of your mamas out there, you already, right when we said August 23rd, mm-hmm. you already have the shoes by the door and the bag packed.
Yeah.
I've had some of you mamas, which I understand, like, when are you opening the nursery?
Let's do this.
So I know you've been ready,
and
your workers
sure.
have, servant leaders have been ready, and you have taken above, I would say, to sanitize. And like, you are just on it, and I appreciate that so much.
Well, no, that's just our heart to do everything in excellence, and that is part of it, safety and everything. That just goes along with it. We have been opening up those classrooms for all of our families to use. One family at a time can go in the nursery classrooms, and that'll continue until August 23rd, of course. So you can continue to do that. Come and see me if you have any questions. I'm always out there on Sunday mornings. But you know, before they come in, it's cleaned.
Yeah.
After they leave, it's cleaned. And so we're just gonna continue to do everything we possibly can do for your babies and for our teachers and servant leaders.
Yes. And parents, if you have any questions about how we're going to do things or how everything's going to look, please feel free to email, to call, and connect with Pastor Natalie and Pastor Josh. They would be happy, like she said,
absolutely.
To answer any of your questions and concerns.
We want to make sure that you're safe and protected and cared for. And again, we don't like that we've had to put any of this on hold.
Sure.
I know that that's not been our heart, to withhold the ministry from your children. We have done everything that we know how to make sure that not only are you covered, but that your children are covered. And we look forward to that time when we're going to be opening just two and a half weeks from now. It's going to be great. Well, listen, guys, we want to pray. We know that these days, unique days that we live in, our kids, from the smallest infants all the way up to our college kids, they're all experiencing this together. Some are handling it different than others, and we know how challenging it's been for them. Then you add into the equation the teachers and the parents who've had to try to walk through this. So I think it'd be appropriate if maybe, Pastor Josh, if you would first lead us in prayer over our elementary age kids, those that are going back to school, many with masks on for the first time, and what that's gonna look and feel like. Maybe classrooms that used to go from class to class are now in meeting in just one class all day. Pastor Natalie, if you would lead us for our littles, those that are the babies and you know, all the daycare and all the kids ministry area that represents your heart. I know, Michelle, I know you've been a teacher. You have been not only a parent and a teacher, but you've been both in our home. And I would say if you could pray over our teachers and our parents. And then, of course, I want to close out by praying for our youth and our student ministries all the way up through college, because, friends, we need prayer. So would you partner with us in prayer as we pray these together? And maybe, Josh, if you lead us, and then Natalie, Michelle, and myself.
Let's pray. Father, we thank you so much for the day that you've made. You made it so that we would rejoice and be glad in it. So that's what we do today and every day, Lord. Lord, I pray and I ask that that first day of school for the first grader, second grader, third and fourth and fifth grader would be a day of rejoicing, Lord, that they would find your joy in spite of whatever difficulty, in spite of whatever challenge, whatever change, whatever they may see as different or not fun. God, I pray that it would be your joy that would just be in their hearts, God. Lord, I pray over every mom and dad of those elementary school age kids, God, that Lord, I would just silence the fear in their heart. Father God, I just speak against the fear that would say your child is going to have a horrible, terrible time at school. I speak against that in Jesus' name, because we are called to be more than conquerors. So Lord, over that first grader, over that second grader, I speak more than conqueror over them, Lord, more than victorious as they take those first steps back to school, Lord. Lord, I pray that as they go back with all social distancing and all the things that have been put in place to keep them safe, Lord, that you would provide fellowship somehow. Lord, you created us to fellowship, Lord, so I just pray over their fellowship, over their friendships, over their connections at school, Lord, that even in spite of the difficulty that may present itself with these new parameters, Lord, they would find ways to still be friends, to still find friends if they're at school, Lord, in Jesus' name, I just bless them.
Lord God, we just lift up all of our babies, our toddlers, our preschoolers, Lord. God, I just lift them up to you, Lord, and we just declare safety and peace over them as they go to their daycares, Lord, in their daily lives, as they come back to church here, God, as these parents bring their precious treasures to us, Lord, would you just continue to give us wisdom and seek you in how to do this safely and the best way possible, yes, while we still minister to those sweet kids and their families, God. May it be a blessing to them, God. And Lord, we just pray over all the teachers that are in these daycares, God. Would you just give them wisdom, Lord? Would you give our parents of these kids that are even just staying at home, Lord, would you give them peace, God? Would you give them wisdom and how to train up these babies, Lord? The people that are going to be homeschooling for the first time, Lord, we know that that's a challenge, God. Would you just guide us and lead us and direct our every step? In Jesus' name we pray.
Lord, I thank you for our teachers. Thank you for our administrators, yes, and their staff and the counselors, God, that are in leadership over our children. God, they pour so much into our kids day, yes, after day. And God, I just pray strength over them. Lord, I pray safety over them, protection, that as they, many of them have already begun this year, but as they step into this season, which is a different season than they've ever had to teach before, I pray safety and protection over them in the name of Jesus. And God, I pray extra strength over them as many of them are exhausted, not even knowing how this next year is going to look. But God, so please just give them extra strength over their body and over their minds in the name of Jesus. And Lord, I ask that you would give them supernatural creativity, yes, as they are having to wear the mask, or they are having to do things online this year. God, that you would just be there for them and give them the peace that passes all understanding. But Lord, let them walk in a confidence, yes, and knowing that you have given them supernatural creativity of how to reach and how to connect with their students this year. In the name of Jesus. And God, I pray a special prayer tonight over the teachers who are parents themselves. Give them strength, Lord God. Give them extra grace in this season, God, as they are walking in this different season, as we've said. Lord, we thank you, God, and we are looking forward to a great school year in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus.
Lord, I thank you so much for our student ministries, God, for our youth, and for the college age ministry, junior high, high school, middle school. Lord, the unique time that, God, that is just in general, even without a pandemic, that those are unique days for a student. And God, I ask that somehow, some way, you would transform every student and their heart during this school year to recognize the days in which they live and the significance of their life, God, in their school, and the way that they can minister to other students who have walked through challenges and grief and difficulty. Lord, I also pray for those students that are going off to college. I know that this is such a new year for them, with or without a pandemic, but having walked through this now, many of them not being able to walk the normal lines of graduation and now heading off to school with levels of uncertainty. God, I ask that you would give them strength and peace and hope and help and assurance and guidance, strength for this journey. Lord, would you be with them on their journey to college and back home? Yes. Lord, for those that are high schoolers and middle schoolers and junior high, Lord, I pray that you would give them the strength they need to embrace this new normal.
Yes.
And that, Lord, we pray that it would be a short-term new normal, that
yes.
somehow you would
yes.
allow us to go back to a semblance of normalcy. God, we thank you for that, and we give you the praise and honor and glory for every age ministry of this church, this house. Kids and children and students, they represent, God, not just our heart at Dothan First, they represent your heart, Lord Jesus, and we thank you for them all in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Well, guys, thank you for joining with us tonight.
We're excited.
Guys, don't forget, this Sunday, we're going to be releasing some groundbreaking information that you do not want to miss. It's going to be a vision casting Sunday for us in children's ministries, and you don't want to miss it at all. And so we're looking forward to it. We can't wait to see you. God bless you, and have a Jesus-filled rest of the evening. And the Jesus-filled rest of the week. We'll see you on Sunday. God bless you.
Bye, guys.